귀염둥아, 뭐 재미있는 걸 찾았나 보지?
What did you find, my pet? I found a human, an alive human, ready for you to eat.
Hello, it's me, Ginge. Welcome to another episode of the Coma 2 Picture Sisters. I hope you're sitting down with a cup of tea in your hand, cause we're going to have a bumpy ride in this episode. So let's go! What's in his bag? Who do I... Oh no! I pressed the wrong button! Crap. Still getting the hang of things, guys. Still getting the hang of things. Bandage, yes. Bandage. You receive a torn page. Torn pages you collect will appear in notes. These pages may provide revealing lore. Life in Guangzhou, Sumi. It was the autumn of 1938 that I was born to a family of humble means. For 7 years, we lived in our small family house in Guangzhou. My father worked as a farmer harvesting rice and barley. Mother worked at the cotton mills. My older brother Suho and I tended to the chores our parents couldn't see to. In those years, everyone carried their weight. That's what was expected, and we did so with great diligence. Those were difficult years, but we were happy because we had the great comfort of each other's company and laughter. Okay, so I guess that was like the first page of 10 pages. This gate is locked too? Come on. Maybe the staff left some keys behind the bar. I better check once I get the key. A hastily written memo to the cafeteria staff is here. We received cafeteria memo and staff key card. It seems a food service worker was doing overtime. They told her to pick up an underground parking lot key card in the security office. Maybe I can finally get out of this creepy place. I don't think so, honey. I don't think so. Oh, I can't go down here. Okay. Okay, so let's go down here. This way is blocked. Tree, that way is blocked. Okay. Locked. Stuff. A wall of eldritch tentacles have taken root and are growing through this hole. What the heck? I can't pass through this here. What is this big mess of shit? You receive a torn page. Okay, let's see what's on this third page. I won't read that. Gonna find the second page first. Guys, I'm like recording this at like 3:48 AM, man. My heart. Why am I doing this? Why? Why? These bodies are so scary, you can never get used to that. Whoa! What the? I heard a sound. Come here. Receive torn page. Okay, page 2. A fateful day, Sumi. August 15, 1945 was the day of my 7th birthday. The nation celebrated its independence for the first time after 35 years. My father believed it to be a good omen that his daughter's birthday should fall on such a day. My mother scolded him for being too superstitious. At the end of that month, he suddenly announced we were selling our land and moving to Seoul to seek better opportunities and be closer to his brother. As a young girl, I still remember our journey to the big city felt like ages. To while away the hours, my brother taught me how to play his recorder. He would continue to tutor long after. Those sessions are now precious memories. Okay. The Seiwa Institute. The months after our arrival in Seoul were turbulent. To my father's dismay, it was a dangerous time of political upheaval. My family settled in an undeveloped city district called... What? Songru. It was most notable for two things then. The distinct presence of Catholic missionaries and the preeminence of the Sewa Institute, owned by a mysterious American family. Our community knew the organization's well for its various outreach efforts. Despite the benefits their development projects did for our district, a suspicious form of secrecy shrouded the Sewa Institute. Ah, I see. Oh man, don't hurt the door. This place is creepy as shit. Oh my god, even more creepy crawly, creepy crawly, creepy crawly, creepy crawly, run! Locked. Why? Good. I heard something. Okay, it's here. What the fuck? It's real body and real blood. What happened to him? I need to call the police. Dot. My phone refuses to work at a time like this. Okay, calm down. And just focus on getting out of here. What in the actual heck? It's like something that's trying to get out of him. Something possessing and trying to get out of him and just kill himself. Kamikaze style. Yeah. A wallet. His name was Yongbei. I don't recognize him though. He received underground parking lot keycard. Alright. Something's gonna come out. Something's definitely gonna come out. What's this? Looks like maze. He must have tried to use it. Doesn't look like it helped though. What could have done this to him? It might come in handy. Maze is a disposable item used to escape an assailant's grabs. A quick time command will appear when captured. Complete the command to use the spray. Oh my god, QTE, really? The parking lot is downstairs. Let's get out of here. God, why are people leaving their money everywhere? You receive a torn page. Let's read this. Learning English. The Sewa Institute boasted its presence in Songbyun between 1945 and 1949. They inaugurated Sewa Hospital and expanded the Sewa Academy, which had been opened since 1932. Westerners largely staffed both facilities. Suho attended the academy and became fluent in English. He had a natural command on it of it, and his intelligence was a source of great pride for my parents. Even taught me how to read and write the language. My admiration for him grew with each passing day. I wanted to be just like him. I still practice using the recorder he had given me so many years ago. It was my personal way of following in his footsteps. Okay, so Sumi's the little sister of Suho. She looks up to him and wants to be like him. Stick. Should be here. B1F. Okay, here I go. It's no good. The keycard won't work unless the door has power. Alone underground. This is not how I imagine spending my night. Yikes. Yeah, I don't want to spend a night in the underground car park alone as well. Oh my god. Can you calm down, woman? Can you calm down? And just chill. Yes, go. Ah, keep your head. mineral water. Take this later. Later. You receive a torn page. Okay, the summer of 1950. Nothing could have prepared us for the horror to come in the summer of 1950. Our entire district fell into turmoil when word arrived that North Korean forces had crossed the 38th parallel. My family listened to a radio announcement from President Ri, who urged citizens to stay in Seoul and trust the government in spite of the impending danger. It's always like that. Everything. Do not panic, people. Just trust the government. The government has all of you safe. Always. That's what the government always says in every country. Agree with me, right? You guys agree with me? Okay, so moving on. My family knew what was coming, so we quickly packed what we could carry and fled the burning city on foot. We made it across the Han Bridge moments before our own forces destroyed it. It was the most difficult journey in our lives. Through much suffering and heartache, we finally found our way to Busan. Train to Busan. Train to Busan flashback! The last city standing. It was there that Suho, then a 16-year-old boy, announced that he would join other students as volunteer soldiers. I protested in anger to no avail. Okay, so Suho became a soldier, young boy soldier. Sumi was afraid of losing the brother. Got it. This looks like the generator. I may be able to restart the power here. Ah, QTE! Fucking QTE! Sounds like it worked. Oh shit. Oh shit. Huh? Did someone just come in? Don't tell me.
거기 누구세요?
Hey, hello? Come on, girl, you can't just say that. Don't just scream out that. Don't just scream hello, you're just gonna get killed. Have you ever watched any horror movie? Protagonists die that way!
누구니? 어서 나와.
She has a sexy voice, man. Who's there? Please come out. My god. No. Miss Song? Thank god. I thought I was the only one here. Oh Jesus, no. What did you find, my pet?
I found a human, an alive human, ready for you to eat.
Another trespasser skulking about our sweet home. What? The moment I press the button to the next page, she is going to chase me. And I hate being chased.
그렇다면 그게 환영해주지 않을 수 없지. 그렇지?
How about we give her a proper welcome to our lovely school? Fuck. I think he just passed. Gotta run to the underground parking lot now. Okay. Whoa, the whole screen shakes. Run, let the life run like your life depends on it. She's just right behind me, she looks scary as fuck. As I've decimated lots of people with those bloody clawed hands, man. No, massive success. I've gotta get away from this cycle. Huh? Oh, there's such a bright light all of a sudden. Who are you? Get on now! She can't keep up. Who the hell is this guy?
Wait, who are you?
Yeah, who are you?
안에 들어가서 숨어 있어. 난 저 녀석을 유인할게.
Get inside and find somewhere safe. I'm going to lead her away.
도대체 누구지?
Who was that? Yeah, who was that? 송준 police office. Was that Miss Song? Something's terribly wrong. I don't think tonight we'll get any stranger. She jolted me off the police office. I better file a report. Mom and Dad must be so worried right now. I'm sure they feel relieved to hear from me. The police office also looks very fucking creepy. Okay guys, I'm gonna end this episode here. My heart cannot take this anymore. I need to prep myself up for the next episode. I'll try to release the next episode on a Sunday. So if you want to see more episodes of this series, stay tuned. Okay, thanks for watching. See ya!